بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد الفاتح لما أغلق وخاتم لما سبق، نصر حق بالحق والهادي إلى صراطك المستقيم على آلهك قدره ومقداره العظيم. شعر محمد ماهي سيسا. With each click of his tasbih, I move past me into the everlasting. With each click of his tasbih, it casts me into a sea without shore. Did Allah not ask me, am I not your Lord? Yes, but since then I've been born and I've been deluded by the world of forms. Been deluded by the world of forms. Until his grandfather brought forth the deluge in a storm that will wash away all else besides the face of our Lord. And his grandson, why else did his father and mother make him Mahi, except that he would obliterate all the idols that I've built inside of me? So much so that you don't see me only see say say. You don't see me only see say say. With each click of his tasbih, I am moved past me into the everlasting. With his ha illallah, I am in Allah. Made me so happy, I thought I'd cry. Made me so alive, I thought I'd die. O revealer and concealer, the poet's pen would splinter if I dared to enter into the reality of my master and mentor. In all of my years, I've only known winter. But your being summoned both spring and summer, a land of wonders with names too great to mention and their quantity too great to number. Why else did his father and mother make him Mahi, except that he would obliterate all of the idols that I built inside of me? So much so that you don't see me, you only see see see. You don't see me, you only see see see. Don't see me, only see see see. You 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 don't see me.
Ya Rasulullah, ya Mustafa, ya Hatim al-Anbiya, ya Shaykhana wa wasilatina ila Rabbina al-Qutub al-Maktuma wa al-Khatim al-Muhammadiyya Sayyidina wa Mawlana Ahmad al-Tijani. Ya Shaykhana, Sahibu Fayda, Braham Bayin, Ya Sheikh Ali Sisi, Sayyidi Ali Sisi, Ya Sheikh Hassan Sisi.
In his life, it was enough for maybe 6 or 7 great lives. Like just as a humanitarian.
Yes.
Just if we were to leave everything else off.
Yes.
Just as a humanitarian, it would be enough to call that man a great man if he just did that.
Exactly.
In the realm of Quran and Hafiz and preserving the Quran, it will be enough to say that this is a great preserver of the Quran. Spiritual teacher and a spiritual father, the number of people that he was sustaining spiritually, it would be enough to say this was a great wali, great master. All these things, it boggles my mind how it could happen in such a life, like in one life, and the life that we're talking, this part of the life is relatively short from the time he gets the Khalifa to the time when he transitioned. I wanted to speak about what he was, because the different people I speak to, there was something different to them. So who was Sheikh Hassan Sisi to you?
Who is a 14-year-old from Detroit, Michigan. She completed Sheikh Hassan Sisi's 3-year Hafiz intensive program at the African American Islamic Institute in Medina by Kalak. She completed her recitation this Ramadan, completing her khatam during the last 10 days of Ramadan. During the same time, she also placed top 10 in more than 500 students in a Senegalese regional Quran competition. After all that, she is also right now an honor student in 9th grade at Ali Khalak Academy in Detroit, Michigan. Also, she is currently teaching Quran classes at a Detroit community masjid. So we just want to have this a good time.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد الفاتح لما أغلق والخادم المصاب ناصر الحق بالحق والخادم ناصر الصراط المستقيم على عليا خطر ومقدار العظيم الحمد لله. I wanted to welcome my family. So when I was speaking with Ajib and the programming committee regarding this, I was very reluctant to even, you know, come and do any of this. I wanted to help, but when I thought about it, and the confirmation is today, I think 80% of you here knew me when I was 2 years old, at least. So it's a special honor to be able to stand in front of you and welcome you all to the 4th annual Sheikh Hassan Sisi Ziyara. Wallahi, thank you so very much for coming out to show your love and support for what we're trying to do. There's too many people for me to even point out. So we'll allow the evening to continue, inshallah. But I have to welcome our special invited guests, and specifically, Sheikh Mahi Sisi, our Sheikh, the brother of our Sheikh. We welcome you, Sheikh. We're honored by your presence. And also, we have a special guest, the daughter of our Grand Sheikh, Haji Ibrahim Nyas, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who is here as well. And they asked you, alhamdulillah, you're welcome, inshallah. So without further ado, we'll go ahead and commence because we're late already, inshallah.
So this year, as you may know, our program is, the theme is promoting a legacy of education. So this year, earlier this year in October, Malala Yousafzai became the youngest person to win the Nobel Peace Prize. At only age 17, she was honored for her relentless commitment to fighting for the right to education for all. Malala recognized that education was a critical tool for achieving justice and equality. This link between justice and education is rooted in the Islamic tradition. This year, we found it really fitting to honor Sheikh Hassan's legacy of promoting education. Throughout his life, he worked tirelessly for this cause. This began with his own educational pursuits. His accolades include memorizing the Quran at age 10 and pursuing Islamic scholarship, which culminated in acquiring over 600 ijazas from some of the world's most renowned scholars. In addition to this commitment to Islamic knowledge, his educational achievements took him to three different continents. He received his bachelor's in Ain Shams University in Egypt, his master's in London at the School of Oriental and African Studies, and began pursuing a PhD at Northwestern University in Illinois. In his own family, he encouraged and supported many of his children to complete the memorization of his Quran, of the Quran, including many of his children and one of his daughters who is here today. This mirrors an example that is set by his grandfather, our beloved Sheikh Ibrahim Nias, radiallahu anhu, who encouraged women to compete with men in the acquisition of knowledge. A number of Sheikh Ibrahim's children memorized and taught the Quran, including Sheikh Maryam Nias, an accomplished woman scholar who founded and continues to run one of the most prominent Quran schools in Dakar, Senegal.
As a matter of fact, our guest today, alhamdulillah, this is the daughter of our Sheikh, Hazrat Nias, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. This is a bit unscripted, but I have to give you a little bit of history with regarding to this woman. And this is an attestation of the greatness of Islam and Tariqa Tijan and Fader of Sheikh Ibrahim Nias radiallahu ta'ala anhu. This woman, every single year, at the behest and the advisement and the encouragement of Sheikh Hassan Sisi, she has a big conference of women who come and they recite the Quran and khatmi the Quran thousands of times. Every single year. I think the last one, Ustaz Barhama Job actually presided over the conference, and I forget that it was some, like maybe 20 or 30,000 Khatmi Qur'an that they, something like that, something outrageous. That they, and this is something she does every single year. So we have to honor her, because she is also maintaining and establishing the legacy of our Sheikh, Haji Ibrahim Nias, at the encouragement of our Sheikh, Sheikh Hassan Sisi. So thank you. Please show your appreciation for saving.
In addition to his personal commitments with his family and his other accomplishments, Sheikh Hassan's commitment to providing educational access to children actually led him to establish the African American Islamic Institute, among which has a Quran school which trains students, including Makia and other graduates here, from throughout the world in Quran memorization and Islamic sciences. This evening, we hope to honor Sheikh Hassan's relentless commitment to promoting education. And with that, we'd like to introduce our first speaker, who is going to give a little bit of context and background information about Islam in West Africa and the Tariqa Tijaniyya. Our first speaker is Professor Suleiman Bashir Jin, who is a professor of French and philosophy at Columbia University in the city of New York. His academic interests include history of logic African philosophy and literature, and philosophy and Sufism in the Islamic world. In 1982, Professor Jin returned to his native country of Senegal to teach philosophy at Sheikh Anta Diop University in Dakar, where he became the Vice Dean of the College of Humanities. The former president of the Republic of Senegal, Abdou Diouf, named him Counselor for Education and Culture, a position which he held from 1993 to 1999. He has also taught at the prestigious Northwestern University for many years. We are honored to have him speak tonight about the history of Islam in the Tijaniyya in West Africa. Thank you.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد الفاتح لما أغلق والخاتم لما سبق ناصر الحق بالحق والهادي إلى صراطك المستقيم وعلى آله حق قدره ومقداره العظيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. I would like first and foremost to express my gratitude for this huge honor and the blessing of being here. I would have considered an immense honor already just to be invited to this fourth annual Sheikh Hassan Cissé Ziyarah in any capacity, let alone as a speaker at this gathering in the presence of Sheikh Muhammad Al-Mahi Ali Cissé, whom I salute. I would like to thank Nasrul Ilm America and my brother Rasul Miller in particular for the wonderful opportunity that was given to me. So I've been asked to say a few words of introduction about Islam in West Africa in general, and in particular to say a few words about Tijaniyya. Let me speak first of Islam in Africa in general, just in order to emphasize one point of history, which is worth remembering, that we all know, but it is worth remembering always and meditating often. This is about the first encounter between Islam and the African continent, which occurred, as you know, in the early years of the Muslim religion, while Islam was still in its infancy, around the year 615. Roughly 5 years after the beginning of Revelation. I'm referring here, of course, to the first Hijra, known as Hijra il al-Habsha, or Hijra to al-Habash, or Abyssinia, as the empire of Aksum, present-day Ethiopia, was also called then. Because Muslims were persecuted by the Meccans in Mecca, in particular, the weakest among them, that is to say those who did not benefit from the traditional protection of powerful tribes, it had been decided by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to send them seek refuge in Aksum, the capital city of the Christian Empire of Abyssinia. After a first abortive return, a few months after they got there, due to the false rumor that actually Mecca as a whole had converted to Islam, and this was the first rumor. So after that abortive return, and after the king of Abyssinia himself had granted them asylum in spite of a demand from Mecca, formulated by an important delegation, the group who went to Abyssinia stayed there until the second Hijra to Medina. It seemed to me important that we remember this well-known event of Islam to just recall that Islam in its first years put itself under the protection of Christianity in the name of Abrahamic fraternity and with the belief in the one God. It is important, secondly, to remember that this happened on the African continent and that the encounter of Islam in the land of Africa happened under those auspices of peace between religions and positive tolerance, a tolerance that means respect. And this is indeed a fundamental trait of Islam in Africa in general, a fundamental trait of Islam in West Africa in particular, and a message that has been cultivated by the Sufi brotherhoods that have flourished in that region known as the Bilad al-Sudan, the land of the black people. And this is also a message that Sheikh Hassan Cisse has tirelessly worked at spreading. Islamic presence in the valley of the River Senegal was already a reality when, at the beginning of the 11th century, in the kingdom of Tekrou, then situated in the northern part of today's Senegal, known as Fouta Toro, Warjabi became the first king to convert to Islam. He adopted Islamic legislation for Tekrou, which became progressively a Muslim territory. By the time he died in 1040, this was really accomplished already and established. And you know that 1040 is a couple of decades before the adventure of Al-Murabitun, the Al-Murabi, started from that region of the river Senegal northwards, founding Marrakesh, and going to strengthen Muslim presence in Al-Andalus in southern Spain. The Muslim faith then continuously spread towards the southern regions where learning centers were founded and flourished, disseminating Islamic knowledge and practices. This happened throughout West Africa, from the Atlantic coast to east of Lake Chad. Needless to say, we all remember all the different empires that actually were founded upon Islamic grounding. The Mali Empire, founded in the early 13th century, and which reached its peak in the 14th century, followed by the Songhai Empire and the Askia dynasties, and also further east, we remember historically what was the Kanem, Bornu, and Bornu kingdoms. So I jump over centuries to come to the period that is of interest to us when we talk about the Sufi brotherhoods. A phase of accelerated Islamization occurred, as you know, at the end of the 18th century and throughout the 19th century. In northern Senegal, for example, a new regime known as the Almamia took power in 1776. The leadership was headed by an Almami, a local pronunciation for an imam in the Fulani language, who was elected from among the members of a new class of religious families known as the Torawe. The region of Fouta Toro is also the homeland of Sheikh Omar al-Fouti, who led a religious war for expansion of Islam in the regions east of the river Senegal. And Sheikh Omar al-Fouti also fought against the French armies. He died in 1864 in Banjagara, a region which is situated in present-day Mali. Before him, speaking of the spread of Fulani jihad, of course, we had also Usman Dan Fodio and the establishment of a caliphate in the region that we know now as northern Nigeria. But these phases of jihad were followed by the very phase of the spread of Islam through the brotherhoods. And that is the time of the massive Islamization of our region of West Africa, or the Bilad al-Sudan. This paradoxically occurred during colonial time. I always like to stress the paradox that it is actually the French colonial administration which Islamized most of West Africa. Because that colonial administration had constructed roads and railways and thus had helped Muslim traders and Muslim followers of brotherhoods to widely travel preaching Islam to local populations. And at the same time, the people who had witnessed the collapse of the traditional kingdoms they lived in and the disruption of the social order they were used to in their homelands were willing to stand behind the religious leadership of masters known as Sheikh or Marabout, which is a French deformation of Al-Murabitul, the very Al-Murabit that I spoke earlier about. As their influence grew rapidly, these leaders became the target of the colonial administration. And so those Marabout headed the Sufi orders, which provided to the new converts education in the Muslim religion primarily. And this has been emphasized again and again, especially when you talk about a ziyarah of Sheikh Hassan Cissé, the word education is going to pop up all the time. These Sufi brotherhoods, and especially the Tijaniyya, also provided the social structure of a fraternity organized around a sheikh and a religious center where periodical gatherings would take place. This history explains why Islam in West Africa is massively a mystical Islam, where the role of Sufi orders is so important. Particularly, I would say in Senegal, Muslim leaders in Senegal are those of the Sufi orders, which are the main characteristic of the Muslim faith in that part of West Africa. Sufi orders or mystical paths are known, of course, throughout the whole Islamic world. Thus, the Qadriya, or the path of our master Abdul Qadir al-Jilani, who died in the 11th century in Baghdad, or the Tijaniyya, the path of our Sheikh Abu Abbas Ahmed al-Tijani, who died in 1815 in Fez, Morocco. All those turuq have local leaders called Sheikh or Selim or Cherno, and many followers in Senegal. Two important other orders, known as the Mouridia and the Layene, can be considered as specific contributions of Senegal to Sufism. Now, let me concentrate on the Tijaniyya order for my final point. And instead of telling you or retelling you a history that you well know, which is the history of Tijaniyya and its spread in West Africa and the Bilad of Sudan from Nigeria to Senegal, not to mention Sudan and other regions of the world, I would rather come back to the point I started with, a point of openness and education to tolerance that is characteristic of the mystical dimension of Islam in general, and in particular, the path of Sheikh Nasheh Abu Abbas Ahmed al-Tijani, radiallahu anhu. To just remind myself and all of us of the important point of doctrine that the Sheikh taught about tolerance in the name of human fraternity. The point is reported in the Jawahir al-Mani, and the Manian Tijani master Cherno Bokar Sarif Tal has made it the core of his teaching of Islam. The point in question is the unequivocal, strong, firm affirmation that yes, indeed, God's love embraces also the so-called infidel. Not just the followers of the other religions of the book, because they are children of Abraham, but human beings in general, because they are children of Adam. God's name, Rahman, has taught the Sheikh al-Tijani, commands that we hold in the highest possible value the nobility of those he has called the children of Adam. And this implies valuing each and every life as embodying humanity in general, as the Quran itself said. The reason why I decided to end my short presentation on that point is obvious, because this is a lesson for our time. And our Sheikh Ibrahim Anyas has often reminded us of the saying that the Sufi Ibn Waqtihi is the son of his time. So we need lessons from our tariqah for our time and our future, not just celebrating a past. So this is a lesson for our time. When we witness that fanaticism teach to take for absolutely nothing human lives, that these fanaticism are prone to excommunicate everybody and labeling everybody infidels. Well, to those fanatics, we have to say that even the infidel, if there were any, would be also embraced by the all-embracing and loving name of Rahman, which is one of the great names of God. Ya Rahman, kulli shayin, embracing everything, wa rahmahu. This may be for the Muslims in particular. And I believe that I would share and remind myself and you of this lesson of tolerance in the times that we are living. And I would like to say thank you again for the blessing of being here. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Inshallah, let's please congratulate him again, alhamdulillah. Thank you, Professor. Alhamdulillah, I think if we were to summarize what the professor just spoke about, it is the lesson of tolerance that all of our sheikhs have come to express to us. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, and we know the reality of Islam. Contrary to what we see in the media, contrary to what we hear from certain outspoken critics, we understand the reality of Islam. And we have to say Alhamdulillah, because that particular understanding, which is the correct understanding, is, as the professor so eloquently put it, filled with love for all of humanity, love for all of creation. And this is, for me, the central message that our Sheikh, who we're here to commemorate and celebrate today, Sheikh Hassan Sisi, came to bring. So Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. May Allah reward you, Professor. Thank you very much. I was asked, I should have said this in the beginning, please, everyone, if you would please put your cell phones on mute or vibrate so that we wouldn't have any interruptions, inshallah. The next speaker is Sister Naima. So I'm going to, I know most of the speakers, I know them personally. So for me, I don't like to read from scripts. I just tell you how I feel about them. But I'll start this the right way. So I'll read it, inshallah. Then I'll tell you my feelings. Sister Naima Halim is a clinical behavioral therapist from Detroit, Michigan. She has devoted as a devoted advocate and patron of international community relations and outreach for the nonprofit African American Islamic Institute, the institute that was founded by our Sheikh Sheikh Hassan Sisi radiallahu ta'ala. She received her master's degree in rehabilitation, counseling, and community inclusion, and certification in rehabilitation, counseling, and therapy, and is currently working toward a PhD in rehabilitation, counseling, and psychology. So I'm not even going to read the rest. She's a Talibah of Sheikh Hassan, a Talibah Bai, a follower of Sheikh Ibrahim Yas Radiallahu, and that's enough of a introduction for a person like this. That is enough. Alhamdulillah, she is one of the pride and joy of our community, and she has worked extensively in the past and currently, inshallah, and in the future for a very long time, inshallah, to come, as a community liaison for Sheikh regarding his medical clinic. So alhamdulillah, I'd like to present her now. She can come and give you a short talk, inshallah. Sister Naima, bismillah.
Assalamu alaikum. Today we're here in remembrance and to pay tribute to Sheikh Hassan Sisi's legacy of promoting, encouraging, and validating education. And this includes health care education. The word legacy is exactly what it means. It's an inheritance, it's an heirloom. And Sheikh Hassan's health care initiative began with the insight of his grandfather, Sheikh Ibrahim Niaz. Sheikh Ibrahim Niaz wanted to establish easier access to quality health care. He discussed it often with Sheikh Hassan. In December 1997, at the dedication and completion ceremony for the opening of the clinic, Sheikh Hassan stated that Sheikh Ibrahim regularly voiced his concerns about the state of healthcare in Cadillac. He discussed the fact that the lack of medical care was and is the major cause of death in rural communities throughout West Africa. The name given to the clinic, and also a title to one of Sheikh Ibrahim's books, Shifa al-Iskam, means to cure the sickness of the nafs, the soul, and the heart. Sheikh Hassan talked often about traveling to Paris with his grandfather, and often also with his father, Sheikh Sayli al-Assise. And these travels were to seek medical treatment and medical care. They also went back and forth for follow-up treatment and preventative care with medicine. So I'll quote from Sheikh Hassan at the opening of the ceremony in 1997. Sheikh Hassan stated, "Our goal is to make available those services that England or Paris has right here in Medina so that we can afford to spend for Hajj and other purposes instead of traveling and spending for medical care. And if Allah helps us to get the same medical attention here in our city than they have overseas and abroad, then we should praise Him." Sheikh Hassan went on to say that when he sat with Sheikh Ibrahim and told him of the idea to open a permanent medical clinic in Medina, Sheikh Ibrahim prayed for the success of the clinic and automatically volunteered the land that holds the clinic today. Sheikh Hassan knew the clinic would serve an important demand in the community simply because of the urgent need of accessible medical care. Those who could afford to travel to Paris, there was a struggle, but there was treatment and there was medical care. However, many of those who cannot afford to travel suffered often from critical and fatal conditions. The clinic significantly impacted the community with the help of collaborations and partnerships with nonprofit organizations and NGOs, non-government humanitarian organizations, such as World Health Relief and Children's Chance, who treated children with special needs with disabilities, UNICEF, the United Nations Children Fund, that recognized Shifa al-Iskam as a baby-friendly hospital and awarded Sheikh Hassan for his diligent work with maternal care and child and infant care. The World Health Organization helped to establish the vaccination program with collaborating with Sheikh Hassan, which is today one of Sheikh Hassan's still most successful healthcare initiatives. This vaccination program worked to eradicate vaccine-preventable diseases and partner with Sheikh Hassan's healthcare education community outreach program that established quarterly free vaccination fairs which served the residents along with people living in the rural communities. U.S. Doctors for Africa helped establish the first mobile clinic, and AmeriCares partnered with Sheikh Hassan to help provide quarterly distribution of free and low-cost medical necessities such as wheelchairs, hospital beds, emergency triage equipment, dental equipment, and medicine from cough syrups, antibiotics, multivitamins, to lidocaine for teeth extractions, other dental materials, and more importantly, anti-malaria medication, including saline solutions and IV irrigation tubes. Also a significant part of Sheikh Hassan's healthcare initiative is bringing in highly trained doctors, nurses, and community healthcare workers. These individuals came from the Gambia, Nigeria, Ghana, France, Sweden, Germany, and the United States. They volunteered their medical services and they trained local doctors and nurses and healthcare workers. They also conducted educational workshops such as nutritional counseling support and universal precautions of hand washing. And these often were live demonstrations on hand washing techniques. And later on down the line, they became, it opened up for local television access for infomercials. Sheikh Hassan especially worked to ensure a better quality of life for women and children, with campaigns to educate the population about human rights violations of female genital mutilation, and also projects to educate the population on the benefits of breastfeeding. Today, Shifa Al-Islam operates with a 50% decrease in maternal mortality, a 35% decrease in child mortality under the age of 5, and a 43% increase in the rate of immunizations against vaccine-preventable diseases such as polio, tuberculosis, and hepatitis. Shifa Al-Islam serves an estimated annual 100,000 people living in the surrounding regions, 8 surrounding regions around Cowlack. And on a busy day, not a good day, but a busy day, Shifa Al-Islam serves 200 patients a day. Sheikh Hassan's legacy of promoting healthcare education is important because it cultivated from Sheikh Ibrahim's dedication of protecting and serving and guiding and teaching the people. And it helped to shape people's own capabilities for sustaining self-help in the areas of education, healthcare, protecting children, empowering women, alleviating hunger and poverty, among others. Sheikh Hassan knows and acknowledges that educating people about taking care of oneself is fundamental to living the overall quality, healthy life of a Muslim. There are no words that we can express to show our appreciation for Sheikh Hassan. The ziyara is great and it's still not enough. We can only appreciate the work that he's done. We can only appreciate his love, his guidance, and his teaching. And it further continues for our appreciation with Sheikh Mahi for guiding us and teaching us in Seda Suleiman. Shukran, alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah, thank you, Sister Naima. You know, wallahi, the legacy of Sheikh Hassan is the legacy of our Sheikh Maulana Haj Ibrahim Nyas, radiallahu ta'ala. You know, we have these type of events, this specific event, we have to say alhamdulillah for Ajib Cisse, Ajib Abdussalam, and Nasr Ilm, and all of the organizations that helped to bring this to fruition. The reason is, this is not something that we get dressed up once a year, come and sit down and listen to each other talk. This is an event that is supposed to enliven our hearts, remind us of the work and the legacy of our Sheikh, and encourage us to continue in that work and that legacy. If that doesn't happen to you here today, then you came for no reason. Wallahi, you came for no reason, because the work is not finished. This is here today. This place is full today. Wallahi, when we were organizing this program, we didn't think that this place would be full. We thought maybe 1/3 of the capacity. But this is a attestation of the love that we all have for our Sheikh. If we say we love our Sheikh, and we are keeping his legacy alive, and his legacy is multifaceted. The healthcare is just one area, one part of his legacy. We can go on and on. His legacy of feeding people, his legacy of educating people. We can continue, right? We can continue. But just this one aspect of his legacy, I'm imploring everyone here, when you leave today, say to yourself, I want to do something to further the legacy, to carry it to the next generation, to help our sheikhs now, who are his successors, inshallah. Please. The next person to speak is Imam Furqan Muhammad from Atlanta, Georgia. He is the Imam of Masjid Mu'minun. I'm not gonna read his bio, because for those of you who know me and my history, all I can say is, at the time of the greatest need in my life, Imam Furqan Muhammad and his sons were the only people there for me at that particular time. Wallahi, our Sheikh Hassan Cisse loves Imam Furqan Muhammad and his family.
He's not a Tijani yet. I tell his son that all the time. He's not a Tijani yet. But even the love he has for our Sheikh and our people and the assistance and the help that he's exhibited over the years, Sheikh Hassan even used to send him to conferences to represent him. The miracle of the father, the secret of the father is in the children as well. His children, I can say I bear witness to this, along with Imam Ihsan, used to be the ones every single day, rain, sleet, or snow, to establish the wazifa. They do a mawlid for Sheikh Hassan Sisi every week. They recite Qasidatul Burda. This is the secret and the miracle of Sheikh that came through the father and is in the children. So we have to say Alhamdulillah. I won't talk too much because I can continue about Imam Furqan, but I'll go ahead and let him speak, inshallah. Please, Imam Furqan, bismillah.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم In by and with Allah's name, the merciful benefactor, the merciful redeemer. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. Wallahu Akbar. Glory be to Allah. All the praise is with Him. And He is bigger. And He is more important than anything else. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. We openly bear witness and testify publicly and verbally that there is no God except Allah, that He is one and alone without partners. And we witness that Muhammad first is Allah's servant, and secondly, His messenger, the prayer and the peace be upon Him. Dear beloved people, brothers and sisters, to all of you who are present, we greet you with the best of the greetings of paradise, the greetings of the angels, the greetings of the prophets. Peace be upon all of them. Assalamu alaikum. I ask Allah always to guide my tongue, to guide my heart, to guide my mind, to guide my words, and bless me to say those things that are needed and to hold back those things that we shouldn't say. Dear believers, dear Muslim, dear friends, we are here for the same reason. We are here for one reason, to honor Sheikh Hassan Sensei. Some of you met him, and maybe some of you today did not meet him. But all of us, we've heard of him, and we know something of him. And I'm grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have met him. And we have a duty to share him with the world. If we don't tell our story, someone else is going to tell it. And if someone else tell it, they're gonna tell it wrong. We have to tell our own story in order for it to be told correctly. Our Sheikh promoted education, which is the number one priority in Islam, is education. Though the Quran contains 114 chapters, over 6,000 ayats, over 80,000 words. We know it began with only 5 ayats. And those 5 ayats address education. A'udhu billahi minash shaitonir rajim. Iqra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaqa insana min 'alaq. Iqra wa rabbukal akram. Alladhi 'alima bil qalam 'alima insan ma lam ya'lam. Read in the name of the Lord who created man for no more than a clot of blood. Read, and thy Lord is most bountiful. For it is He who have taught man the use of the pen and taught him what he would have never known. And today is still the number one priority. The Sheikh was connecting the Muslims in America with the Muslims in Africa. And in particular, the African-American Muslim. The Muslim who was cut off from Islam through 400 years of slavery. The Sheikh was connecting us to Africa. And it is amazing in America, if you're black and you become popular and you get a whole lot of money, you want to go to Paris. You want to go to Europe, but you don't want to go to Africa. And I tell Muslim of African American in this country, African descent, that once you make your Hajj, you should want to go back home. You should want to go back to where you say you come from. And the Sheikh developed so much love for us in this country, for the love of Africa. And if you don't know this, Africa have the potential of being the first Islamic continent in the world. Not country, continent. Roughly, there's over 48 so-called Muslim countries. Country that have 50% or more Muslim population in it. And Africa represents over 33 of those countries. So the potential is so great there. And many of us, we are taught as Muslims in this country here, go to study Islam everywhere but Africa. Don't go to Africa, go to Saudi, go everywhere. And we're saying today, why not Africa? Why not go back home and study Islam? And Allah tell us in the Quran to travel through the earth. Allah command us to travel. And so Islamic education is everywhere, not just in one spot, not just in one place. Allah says in the Quran, whoever helps a person in a good cause shares in his benefit and his blessings. And whoever helps in a bad cause share in his punishment. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever showed a person, aid a person in finding the straight path, and in our Sheikh particular case, not only help us to find it, but help us to stay on that path, that every time that person does a good, Allah give him a share of that good. So I ask you the mathematical question. How many blessings and rewards do you think Sheikh is getting? Every time you do a good, he get a share of that. Dear believers, dear Muslim, I'm very happy and honored to be here. It took money to get here, but we need to make the money Abdullah. So all of the money we used to come here, we made it Abdullah. Fi sabilillah, for the love of Allah, well spent money to be here. And so we want to always give thanks to Allah for giving to us and loaning to us our Sheikh and our Imam, Hassan Sisi. And we should never forget him, and we should never let the world forget him. We should remind the world when they forget him. In my conclusion of my remarks, when you gain knowledge in the West in particular, it's an excuse, because you have knowledge, that you can do anything you want to do. But we know that when you gain knowledge, you have to keep your morals up. So we can't talk about we follow the Sheikh, and he's our teacher. Now he's absent from us, and that's the test. Why would you go back to smoking and drinking? Why would you lower your standard now since he's not physically here? Is even more reason to show the world that we have a good teacher. Though he's not physically among us, not only are we strong, we're stronger, even though his physical presence is not here. So I'm encouraging you to keep your morals up. Don't drop them. Be clean. Be nice. Keep away from the things that are immoral, because that goes along with your knowledge. The brother introducing us tonight, everybody he introduced, he's saying something about them. And I want to say that when people say something about you, the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ had a dua. And this dua is a win-win dua. Say, oh Allah, bless me to be greater than what people say about me. So if people are saying bad things about you, oh Allah, help me to be greater than what they say about me. And if people are saying good things about you, oh Allah, help me to be greater than what people say about me. It's a win-win situation. Dear believers, we are here tonight to commemorate a great man and his legacy, the work that he did for us. And many of our children are born after his death, so we have to tell them about this man. They have to know him through us. I close with this dua. Oh Allah, we seek protection in you from a heart that has no faith, from a tongue that is not straight, from a mind that does not remember you, from knowledge that is not useful, from a soul that is ungrateful, and from a prayer that goes unanswered. We seek protection in Allah from the enemy within and from the enemy without. We ask Allah to protect us from the unknown. As the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ taught us, that Satan has lost all hope in misleading you in anything that's big. So be aware of him in the little bitty thing. So we seek protection from being misled and from being misguided and from misguiding others. I mean.
Thank you very much, Imam. MashaAllah, I have some good news and bad news. Which one do you want first?
Bad.
Okay, the bad news is the good news. We have too many people now. MashaAllah. We have too many people and overabundance of people. So the center administration has informed us to please ask you all to fill in the gaps. Shift, and let's open up some spaces on the sides, inshallah.
All right, we're gonna re-begin now. So as Ibrahim mentioned, and as Imam Furqan was saying, he sent his own children, and actually his grandchildren as well, to study in Medina Baye, Senegal. I was actually there this summer, and I was there about 2 years ago, and both times I saw one of his grandchildren, Nasir, there, studying tirelessly to memorize Quran. So this just speaks to the commitment. Nasir is not the only one. There have been hundreds and hundreds of students, American students, who have gone over there, learned Quran, learned different Islamic sciences, come back and contributed to their communities in the United States. And one of those people is our next speaker, Ihsan Muhammad. Ihsan comes from Atlanta, Georgia. At age 13, similar to Makia, who opened us up for us, he traveled to Medina Baye Kaolack, where he also enrolled in the African American Islamic Institute. He completed his Quran memorization in 1992 at age 17. I guess you can do the math on his age if you want. Thereafter, he returned to the US. Ihsan is a graduate of Tuskegee Institute in Alabama. And after finishing his undergraduate studies, he started the Nasr al-Ilm Atlanta Quran School in 1999. Now he's going to join us and speak about his own personal experiences as an alumni of this international school. So please join me in welcoming Ihsan Muhammad.
As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. Alhamdulillah, all praises in their every varied mode and manner, indeed and in reality, belong to Allah only. And we're sending the salutation and the blessing upon the seal of prophethood and our master, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and upon his family and his companions, and upon his Ali. And We send a salutation and peace upon the hidden pole and the seal of the Muhammadan sainthood, our Sheikh, Sheikh Ahmad al-Dajani, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and upon his family and his companions, and upon his Ali. And we're sending peace and salutations upon the owner of the Fader, or the spiritual flood, the Sheikh of Islam, Sheikh Ibrahim Abdullah Inyas, may Allah be well pleased with him, and upon his family, wherever they are, here and everywhere else, and upon his companions, and upon his Ali, may Allah be well pleased with him. And to the subject of our gathering, alhamdulillah, the product of his Ali and his Fatima, his Hassan, our guide, our sheikh, our teacher, and our connection to everything we have, the Imam Al-Hassan al-Yusisi, may Allah be well pleased with him. May Allah make him well pleased and make us pleased on his behalf. Ameen. And what an excellent product from the Ali and the Fatima of Sheikh Ibrahim and Yasir Allah Ta'ala. And we have seen the results and tasted the fruit of this product. Straight to the matter, Sheikh Hassan's emphasis on education can hardly be encompassed or exhausted in this blessed gathering of ours. And we know that those efforts are so far-reaching that we will continue to see them appearing and continuing, changing and shaping all the communities all over the United States, wherever you see his students implementing, exemplifying, and putting into practice his excellent example. And his example, the standard he set in learning and studying and in helping knowledge, Nasr al-Ilm, is most excellent indeed, and we all bear witness to that. That standard of knowledge was my first impression of Sheikh before I ever laid eyes on him in person. Me and my father, we were introduced to Sheikh Hassan by someone most of you know. His name is Imam Bilal Fadid, may Allah be well pleased with him. He was one of the first people who came to Atlanta and introduced us to the tariqah. Him, along with our dear father and our beloved who passed as well, the hidden Sufi, Brother Jamil Abdul Karim, who also introduced us to tariqah. But one day, Imam Bilal, he took us to his house for lunch, just me and my father. And he showed us pictures of his travels to Africa. And all the way at the end of the book, and this was our first time seeing any picture of Sheikh, as he turned, he would explain, you know, oh, this is Medina, this is the masjid, you know, these are the streets, these are the people. And then he turned to a page of Sheikh Ibrahim, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And my father, he exclaimed, wow, that's a sheikh. That's a real sheikh. And he turned the page and he had a picture of Sidi Ali Sisi, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And he said, these are sheikhs for sure. And when he turned the last page, Imam Bilal Fareed had a picture, a big picture of Sheikh Hassan. And my father looked and he said, this man, he's too young to be a sheikh. And Imam Bilal Fareed, he said, but this man has knowledge, and Allah, he gives whatever he liked to anybody he wants to. And right there, my father was sold. He didn't have to tell me anything else. He knew he was gonna take me to study in Senegal, alhamdulillah. So that was our initial impression of Sheikh. And Sheikh, he connected us to everything we have, to our heritage, to what Allah has blessed us with, through education. because he founded the school implicitly and explicitly with the intention to connect us to our heritage and to teach us. And that was his, that was one of his missions. He founded the African American Islamic Institute and invited our parents to bring us to live with him and to study with him. And Sheikh Hassan, he welcomed us in a way that we had never seen before. To the point where some of us would be embarrassed by his generosity, by his kindness. And he would soothe us by saying that it's okay because the child of the spirit is closer to the sheikh than the child of blood. Only if the child of blood take their sonhood or their daughterhood and put it to the side and approach as a student, then they get both. Otherwise, the student of the spirit is closer. And then we would be comfortable with that. And this thing, he showed it to us in deed and in word always. As for me and my family, it was important for us to connect to our heritage, to this cultural heritage, as well as to learn about Islam. And I remember my father and the father of my brother here, Bilal, Brother Ahmed Abdullah, radiallahu ta'ala, who also passed, they used to always say, sit around in the shop, you know, Allah always said, he sent the warner or the guide as a person for amongst themselves. And they would say, وَإِلَىٰ عَادٍ أَخَاهُمْ هُدَىٰ وَإِلَىٰ ثَمُودَ أَخَاهُمْ صَالِحًا. So for you guys, for sure, we can't just send you to somebody who is not you. We have to put you in the hands of somebody that's from amongst your own. So not only they'll teach you Islam, but that you will learn about yourself in and out. And though our parents intended that we really get this cultural exchange, that we connect to our heritage, Sheikh always emphasized the Islamic and the spiritual aspect over everything. And he would say to us, anyway, this culture belongs to you. Take what you like. Whatever you see that's good, take it, it's yours. Whatever you see that's foolish, leave it. Leave it with the people. Your parents, they're not killing themselves to send their money for you to learn about the culture. They sent you to learn about your Islam. And he always encouraged us in his example and his deed. You could always see Sheikh in the earlier days, whenever he had downtime, reading the Quran in his courtyard, walking around, reciting Quran, always visiting us in the schools. And if Sheikh saw you walking, even when school was not in session, you better be on point, because for sure he was going to inquire about your progress. And unbeknownst to us at the time, he kept a very firm thumb on every single thing that we did, and he managed every aspect of our education, jot by jot. And he showed us and told us that he thought very highly and expected the best from us at all times. And that was something for us, because we know as a people, that's not something that we were, that's not something that was drilled in us from the beginning. Something quite the opposite was being put in our psyche. And Sheikh Hassan, he worked hard to eliminate that. We all heard him say many times, Don't say, oh, Shaq, I'm an American. Oh, Shaq, I wasn't born Muslim. Oh, Shaq, I'm too old now. Don't say that. You can do anything. You deserve anything. But you have to work hard for it. This Islam is based on hard work. If you work hard, then Allah will give you everything. And he showed us that, and he taught us that. And alhamdulillah, we took it to heart. And for me, myself, and I'm sure that I speak for many, it changed my thinking of myself, and it changed the way that I seen myself, and that I saw myself. And alhamdulillah, Allah gave us success. The seeds of learning that Sheikh has planted, they continue to sprout and to bear fruit. And all of the educational initiatives that Sheikh put in place, they're being maintained, continued, and even expanded under the leadership and example of our Sheikh and our guide, our Murshid, Sheikh Muhammad Al-Mahi Ali Sisi. May Allah prolong his life for our sake with health and provision. Alhamdulillah, those students who studied under Sheikh, they are now in turn spreading that knowledge and implementing all over. As was mentioned, even our young sister Makia, who just finished, as soon as she touched ground, she began teaching and working in the community. Our brother Kafani Sise, the imam, has begun an Arabic language program in Detroit. Our brother Sidi Yusuf, the son of the imam, and the son of the imam, has started a nationwide Quran reading every month. In Atlanta, alhamdulillah, many people are working as well. They mentioned the school. In addition to the school, we're implementing what we learned from Sheikh every week. We have a weekly mawlid every week for Sheikh. We have the monthly Quran reading as well, and the weekend program for adults and children. And in New York, so many things to mention, but that's just blessed event itself with our brother Sidi Ajib and Ibrahim, who you know so well, and everybody working with them, our brother Kaaba, just to bring us together for this blessed gathering. And even in Senegal itself, the students are working there. We have our sister and the wife of our Sheikh, the Hafiza Sayyida Kubra, who has established a school in Medina itself, teaching, and she's carrying on the legacy of our surrogate mother, the Muqaddima, who received directly from the hand of the father of our Sheikh, Sister Karima Abdul Karim. She's carrying that legacy on of caring for our children, the children, and giving them a home away from home. And alhamdulillah, to further our end and to finish, we just announced that we have founded an organization called African American Islamic Institute Alumni Organization, and which is pretty self-explanatory. But our main initiative, inshallah, is to hold a tri-annual celebration to coincide with the three-year intensive program that Sheikh Hassan set up to celebrate every time somebody finishes from the school, not only to celebrate the Quran, not only to celebrate education, and to celebrate the individual and the efforts put forth, but also to advertise, for lack of a better word, the Quran, to further the message and to promote the school to raise funds, inshallah, to expand the school and to help that work that's still going on today. And inshallah, I hope that everyone here who is an alumni will participate in that effort so that we can work together and promote the legacy that Sheikh Hassan has left. Inshallah, may Allah make it easy for us. May Allah make it easy for us to come together. For sure, we all have one spiritual father. We have too many things in common. The small things that if they are different between us, or they vary between us, they're so minuscule and minute that we have to put them aside. We don't have an alternative. We have to work together and we have to see us through, inshallah. May Allah bless us and may Allah forgive us. As-salamu alaykum.
Alhamdulillah. Before we continue, I have to welcome someone. He is the grandson of our Sheikh, the son of our Sheikh, Papa Dam, Sheikh Bai Papa Dam. We welcome you, Sheikh. May Allah bless us with the presence of all of these esteemed people, and then the presence of you all as well. The reason why I say this is because in the audience today, I'm seeing the pioneers. The speech Brother Ihsan just gave is a speech of miracle. It's a miracle and a blessing to our parents. No way can we commence with this without first thanking our parents. Our parents took a risk. Our parents, because of their faith, because of their love of Sheikh Ibrahim Anyas that was instilled in them by Sheikh Hassan Sisi, because of that love, they took the biggest risk that a parent can take, which is to send their child away, thousands of miles away, in the hands of someone that they barely knew. Wallahi, that's a karama. That's a miracle in and of itself. Wallahi, for all of our parents here, my mother's here, I have to respect and honor her, right? My mother's sitting right there. I have to respect and honor her. Why? Because, wallahi, she took a risk and sent her children. And if any of you know my mother, me, I'm older now. But if I have a cold, right? I was coughing just now, she's worried. So how about when we were 8, 9 years old? How about that? And then to send us away. And some of them, they went and saw for themselves first before they sent their children. Desert, hot, malaria. But what did they see? They saw in the midst of all of this, Allah. They saw knowing Allah. So they said they wanted their children to know Allah in the same way. There's no work that our generation, my generation, can do to surpass what they did. None, because we know it now. We knew it from youth. These people came and they learned about it in their older age, and then they sent their most precious thing, their children, to go and learn about it. That's a proof of their faith in Allah himself. So we have to thank them. Wallahi, we have to thank all of you. Thank you. I'm thanking you all on behalf of your children. This is the legacy of what you put forward through Sheikh Hassan, which is from Sheikh Ibrahim Anyas, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. We have to thank them and honor them. And for my peers, this is our work. We organize this, my age group. I have one gray hair only, alhamdulillah. We organize this, we set this up. There's certain things you can take pride in Islam. You can take pride in an effort that you put forward to further people towards knowing Allah. That's the greatest thing to take pride in. We can take pride in that. So wallahi, all of us, my age, our peer group, don't drop the banner that was passed to us by our parents. We have to hold the banner up high. Alhamdulillah to our parents. We had Sheikh Hassan. You had Sheikh Hassan. And then Sheikh Hassan now is not present physically, but then he has his khulafa, he has his successors. He has his brothers, he has his uncles, he has his cousins. And we have to say alhamdulillah that we have grasped their cloak and we're following them as the way we follow Sheikh Hassan Sisi. So alhamdulillah, rabbil alamin. The next person that I'm going to introduce, people don't like it because I talk too much sometimes, but I can't help it. This is something important. The next person I'm going to introduce, they have a bio for her as well, and I heard that she insisted that we read the bio, but I'm not going to accept that. It's Haja Shaki Taha Sisi. I don't remember when I first met her. So that means I've known her my whole life. There's no point of first remembrance of when I met her. She's my mother as well. She was my father's, one of his best friends, Ahmed Dimson, one of his best friends. And there's two things that I can say about her that I'll never forget before she comes up and speaks. I haven't talked to her in about 10 years until today. And I'm gonna apologize to you in front of everybody, so we don't have that anymore. We had a conference with another organization through the efforts of Sheikh Hassan, Islamic World International Conference. It happens every 2 years. We had a conference, the last one was last year, and it was about the status of women in Islam. And there was some confusion about whether she was gonna be present or not. She was the first person on my list, wallahi, when we had our programming meetings. But then I understood she was going out of the country, and I just dropped the ball. I apologize, please forgive me. You were the first person on my mind and on the list, so please forgive me. I did it in public, so you have to accept. This woman is a proof of Sheikh Ibrahim Anyas, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. She's a proof, right? Nowadays, the outsiders, and even some of the insiders in our own religion, denigrate women. When I say the insiders in our own religion, our own family, Muslims, some places in the world, they dismiss women and they put women down. Sheikh Ibrahim Anyas, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, lifted the woman up in a degree that hasn't been challenged since the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. No one has done it like Sheikh Ibrahim Anyas, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And Sheikh Hassan, in keeping with that legacy, lifted the women up. So we have to lift our women up, wallahi. Our women are some of the most important amongst the people in the community. The two things that I remember about Haja Shaki and her late husband, Taha Sise, but the thing that he was like my father as well. The nicest person I ever knew. I've never saw him frown, and I never saw him argue with anyone. The two things that I'm gonna say before I introduce her to come up and speak is, you can see someone's love through the actions that they do towards you. You can see someone's love through the actions that they do when you're not present as well. And then there's another love you can see in people's eyes. When they're looking at the one who is holding their hand and guiding them to Allah, you see love in their eyes. It's possible. I saw this when I think I was about 12 years old, when she and my father were talking about Sheikh Ibrahim, Sheikh Hassan, and Allah. I saw it in her eyes, and I wondered, what are they talking about? That this person is, I just see complete love. The second time that I saw it was one time when Sheikh Hassan was here in New York. Everybody was sitting in his room, people were coming in to greet him, and I saw my mother, Haja Shaki, sitting in the corner looking at Sheikh Hassan. At that minute, I understood what it meant to see Allah in everything. I understood what it meant at that minute because I saw somebody witnessing that, wallahi. So wallahi, alhamdulillah for our Sheikh, alhamdulillah for our mother. Without further ado, I'll be quiet. Please, inshallah, come up.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, wa salatu wa salam ala nabi. Sheikh Mahi, distinguished family of our beloved Sheikh Ibrahim Anyas, And beloved students of our beloved Sheikh Hassan Cisse Rabbi Lam Anhu, I greet you with the best of greetings. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, tonight we are honoring Sheikh Hassan's deep and abiding commitment to education, both his personal pursuit of knowledge and his tireless efforts to make literacy and education available to everyone, girls and women, boys and men alike. This topic could take hours to excavate fully, but my words are limited by my unlimited love and your own experiences with our beloved Sheikh Hassan. And so for that reason, my remarks will be brief, and they may be a little redundant because my sister did give some brief discussion of Sheikh's personal educational history. Sheikh Hassan's personal pursuit of knowledge included a bachelor's degree from Ain Shams University in Egypt, a master's degree and certificates in English and French from the University of London, and completion of all the coursework towards a PhD from Northwestern University in the United States, at which point he was recalled to Medina Bay to serve as its beloved Imam. Under his visionary leadership, the African American Islamic Institute established the Quran School, the Arabic School, the Pre-Primary School, the University Al-Hajj Ibrahim Yas Medical School, and the Women's Literacy Initiative that taught women to read and write, to broaden their understanding of the world in which they lived, and to be able to take a more active role in the education of their children. But what I invite us to reflect upon tonight is this. Sheikh Hassan was our school. If we wanted to learn how to be with Allah, if we wanted to learn how to love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if we wanted to learn how to be with the people, if we wanted to learn how to maintain the ties of kinship, if we wanted to learn how to best perform khidmah, if we wanted to learn the best adab, if we wanted to learn compassion, if we wanted to learn generosity, if we wanted to see Quranic principles put into practice, if we wanted to see the character of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam at work in the 20th and 21st centuries, if we wanted to experience true Islam, all we had to do was observe our beloved Sheikh Hassan radiallahu anhu. Sheikh Hassan was a consummate Islamic scholar, possessing not only university degrees, but more than 600 ijazas from highly respected Muslim scholars and institutions around the world. He was superbly qualified to teach the classical texts and the deep spiritual knowledge of Sheikh Ibrahim radiallahu anhu. And he shared his knowledge generously while using it to accomplish his humanitarian mission on a world stage. Those of us who were blessed to be in his presence over the years and observed him carrying out his responsibilities as a consummate sheikh, as imam, as a son, a husband, a father, a brother, a humanitarian, a farmer, a businessman, a friend, can truly say we attended the best school. Because Sheikh Hassan not only taught us how to be excellent Muslims through the study of tafsir, hadith, sharia, and fiqh, usul, and tasawwuf, he taught us by example. Sheikh Hassan taught us how to be a true human being by example. The lessons Sheikh Hassan taught us inform our lives every minute of every day. How to worship Allah, how to love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how to be with our families, how to treat one another, how to benefit Allah's creation. These life lessons live in our minds and our hearts, and most of all, they illuminate and enliven our souls, the souls that Allah will gather on the Day of Judgment. The degrees we earn on that day are not diplomas awarded by university faculty. They are degrees of mercy and forgiveness and reward from our generous and compassionate Lord, who will determine not only how much or how well we learned from the school that was Sheikh Hassan Cisse, but also how well we use that knowledge to benefit Allah's creation. This is a question we must each ask ourselves before Allah asks it of us. May Allah continue to bless and reward and elevate our beloved Sheikh Hassan. And may Allah bless us, his students, with the intention, the commitment, and the ability to honor our beloved Sheikh with our actions, not only with our words. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah.
Thank you all for being here so far. And right now, I want to introduce our next person. It's going to be Habib Rasul Miller. He's going to share a brief word about Nasrul Ilm America, which is a national nonprofit organization started by several of the students of Sheikh Hassan Cisse, radiallahu anhu. There are many great things about this organization, and you're going to hear about them in a second. One thing that I want to highlight is that this is an organization that has been primarily led and supported by, but a lot of active involvement from the young people. A lot of these people are those who have studied abroad, studied in Senegal because their parents sent them, and many of them are others, like myself, who have just seen people our age, seen the elder generations, and even though we have no family history of this tariqa, have just been blown away by the service and the spirit of education. So right now I'd like to introduce Habib Rasul Miller. Thank
you. Assalamu alaikum, family. A'udhu billahi minash shaitan rajim. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammadin al-Fatih lima ughliq wal khatim ma sabaqa an-nasr al-haq bil-haq wal hadi ila siratil mustaqim wa ala alihi haqqa qadrihi wa darajatihi. So I'm not going to stand up here and talk to you guys too long. I just want to give you a little bit of information about the organization who put this auspicious occasion together tonight, Nasrul Ilm America. So Nasrul Ilm America is a nonprofit, community-based organization established several years ago with the goal of continuing the work undertaken by our beloved teacher and Sheikh Hassan Ali Usisi, here in the U.S. To that end, the mission of Nasrul Ilm America is the promotion of Islamic values through education, humanitarianism, and cross-cultural exchange, three of the things that typified Sheikh Hassan's work here in the U.S. and throughout the globe. Our title, Nasrul Ilm America, was given to us by our Sheikh and is derived from the name Sheikh Ibrahim Niyaz, may Allah be pleased with him, gave to his global community, Jamiat al-Nasrul Ilm. The term loosely translates to beneficial knowledge. So, what do we mean by beneficial knowledge? Well, in our tradition, as Muslims, we know that knowledge, or ilm, is not just information. What distinguishes the people of knowledge is what we call amal. And we have the best examples of knowledge that is put into practice by action, like our Sheikh Muhammad al-Sisi. So, we know that knowledge is predicated upon amal, or action. In other words, the possession of knowledge, real knowledge, is characterized by a person acting on that knowledge. Similarly, knowledge is a prerequisite for correct action. And so, since knowledge is more than just information, our approach at Nasrul Ilm America is a holistic one. The promotion of beneficial knowledge entails more than just disseminating facts, but involves comprehensive programs for social justice and social welfare. Take, for instance, the debate around education reform here in America. While elected officials and business people and other corporate nonprofits propose charter schools and teacher accountability, i.e. firing teachers, vouchers, and closing schools to address the achievement gap, a number of scholars have confirmed what most of us sitting here already know, that poverty serves as one of the biggest impediments to learning. Those of us who know about the Black Power struggle and the Black Freedom struggle here in America know about the Black Panther Party being referred to as the greatest threat to US national security by the head of the FBI. Not because they advocated community policing or black self-defense, but because of, you guys know? The food program, the free breakfast program. They fed kids in the morning before they went to school, which eventually shamed the US government into providing free breakfast and lunch for kids from low-income communities attending public schools around the country. Because it's very difficult to learn when you're hungry and your belly is empty. So exhibiting such a comprehensive understanding of beneficial knowledge, our beloved Sheikh Hassan Sisi, as leader of Jamiat al-Nasr al-Ilm, the community of beneficial knowledge, worked tirelessly to feed people, to provide them with access to medical care, and to facilitate moral and Islamic education, as well as what we might call secular education, for scores of students from all around the world. Following Sheikh Hassan's model, which was itself, of course, patterned off the model of the best of creation, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Nasr al-Ilm America has undertaken a number of social programs, which include the Midnight Run, which is a program we do in collaboration with one of our teachers, Sheikh Amin Abdul Awi, where we take food and clothing to homeless people several times throughout the year. Food, clothing, toiletries, different things like this. And we've serviced hundreds of people, homeless people, and indigent people throughout New York City with this program. The food program in Senegal, where we actually send food and resources to Senegal to support what our sheikh are already doing on the ground to feed people and support people. Our efforts to support the African American Islamic Institute and Quran School established by Sheikh Hassan, which you guys have heard a lot about tonight. And of course, programs like this one, where we bring our teachers, decorated West African scholars, to diverse communities throughout the US, not just in New York City, but all around. Our goal is to expand these programs. Right now, with the Midnight Run, we're able to feed a few hundred people several times throughout the year, but eventually we want to turn this into a soup kitchen, a food pantry, a clothing closet, perhaps even a homeless shelter. These are the things that these are not just pipe dreams, these are the things that we're actually working towards. The Quran school, we want to be able to support the Quran school that so many of us have benefited from, either by studying there themselves, or people like me who didn't study there but are able to have access to real Islamic knowledge from homegrown people from here who studied and memorized the entire Quran. We benefited from that, so we want to be able to give back by supporting to expand the Quran school so that even more people can go and benefit, and even have exchange programs where people from different communities around the country can go and see what West African Islam, what our model of Islam looks like. And of course, when I say West African Islam, it doesn't mean to say that, you know, this is the only place where Islam looks like this, but it's one of the places that we've connected to. So we want people to see the sweetness of Islam, and to see what Islam looks like when it's embodied in its complete way. So in light of the various crises around the world, like debilitating poverty on the continent, and right here in America, hunger, extremism, which we know to be born out of desperation and hopelessness faced by disenfranchised people more so than any particular religious ideology, and lack of access to quality education, both moral and political, as well as secular, with these goals in mind, Nasr al-Ilm America is working to expand and increase these efforts with more holistic, comprehensive programming to support beneficial knowledge. That is, knowledge which translates into even more action in service of humanity. And of course, as you know, this kind of work requires resources. So if you like what you see, you like what you've seen, you like what you've heard, you like what we're trying to do with this organization, then we ask you and invite you to support us with your prayers, with your dua, which is something that everybody can give, with your sweat, with your work and with your effort, and of course, with your dollars as well. And so we have passed around some envelopes and forms with information on how you might make a contribution tonight or pledge to make a contribution in the future. I hope everybody got them. If you didn't get them, you should be getting them quick, fast, and in a hurry. And when you leave here tonight, sitting outside at the table where you registered, where you gave us your information when you first came in, you'll find brothers Yusuf and brother Zakir. Raise your hands high, jump up and down the waves, so you can see.
So you can leave your contribution with these brothers to make sure that we get it. And please stay tuned. Please check out our information online. We're gonna keep you guys in tune with the email list. Please continue to support us with your dua and with your support. Thank you all so, so much for coming tonight. Assalamu alaikum.
Everybody, please don't get restless. We have a little bit to go till our Sheikh Mahi will be coming up soon. But just to piggyback just a little bit on what Habib said, my teacher, my beloved teacher, Haji Ibrahim Mudaris, I think most of you know him here. You know, whenever he talks to me, he always mentions what Sheikh Ibrahim mentions, what Sheikh Hassan mentions. And that is, the best and the first way to give is through your wealth. Me, I'm not a Quran scholar, I can't even say it in Arabic. But he expresses the best and the first way to give is through your wealth. We are a poor community, but wallahi, our pennies can move mountains. So please contribute, inshallah, please contribute. Contribute, and if you don't have wealth, contribute with your hands. Help us, inshallah, take the legacy of our shuyukh to a level that's unsurpassed. And we have that opportunity and we have that ability, inshallah. The next piece that I'm gonna say piece because it's not necessarily a talk. Sister Sukina, she is one of the family of the Tijaniya and the Feda from the United Kingdom. She traveled all the way here from Britain to the United States just for the ziyarah. So the ziyarah is truly international. And we want to, and also, Brother Rashid from Trinidad, alhamdulillah, welcome. So it is for sure, Brother Abdul Ghani from England, it is for sure international, and our Sheikh is showing me the international flavor of the audience, alhamdulillah. So Sister Sakina has a special talent, and she's dedicated this talent to serving Islam, to serving Tariqa Tijan, and to serving the Feda. So we're going to go ahead and introduce her, but I'm going to let Samiha come and say something because I'm hogging the microphone, so she has to say something.
Yeah, okay, the only reason I'm gonna say something is because Ibrahim was talking to it, not because I planned. So I'm gonna read her bio and then I'm gonna tell you a little bit more about her. Sakina is a spoken word poet from London in the UK. She is one half of the female hip-hop duo Poetic Pilgrimage. She has performed in stages in countries throughout the world, including South Africa, Morocco, Greece, Austria, Scandinavia, throughout the United States, and of course, her own home country of England. Her work has been covered by Al Jazeera, BBC, and other prominent media outlets. Sakina's spoken word invites listeners into the spiritual journey and heart of women striving on the path of Allah. She recently returned from an eight-month stay in Medinabai, Kerala, where she too studied Quran under Hajia Kubra Askari Sise, and spent significant time with Sheikh Muhammadu Mahi Sise and Sheikh Tijani Sise. So most of the people here tonight have been people who live in America, who have roots in America, and would be considered American. Now, Sakina represents part of this international community that we have. In London and in the UK, there is a growing Tijani population. Many of these are the Nigerians that who are already there, the Ghanaians already there, and other communities who are already there. However, just like in the United States, where we have an indigenous population of Tijanis, in the UK, we also have a growing indigenous population of people born and raised in Britain with roots there who are coming to the Tijani Tariqa. And one of the champions of this, and one of the people who helped spread this with her beautiful work, with her inspirational words, with just the light that we've talked about already so much, is our sister Sakina. So please welcome her now. Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum. I'm experiencing two emotions being here right now. One is extreme nerves, and the second is extreme honor. Last week, I didn't even know that I would be here today. And this morning, I didn't even know that I would be on this stage. So alhamdulillah, thank you. Alhamdulillah, I'm so honored to be here. I think I'm just gonna start with my first piece. This piece is very much about the moment. The fact that like sometimes we are in a place and we may not even plan to be here, but Allah just brought us here together. I'm sure there are many people that may have even planned to come here last minute and they're here, or some people that maybe had wanted to come but Allah just didn't facilitate it for them to be here. So those of us who are here, like Allah wrote for us to be together, and for that reason, I love you. So that's the name of my first piece, and I hope you like it. Are you guys good?
Yeah.
Alhamdulillah. Okay, I'm so nervous, please. Okay, can I just say one thing before I start? So I've had the opportunity to perform in many places, alhamdulillah, but today I think I'm experiencing the most nerves I've ever experienced in my entire existence, and I think that's because I'm performing before my beloved Sheikh Mahi, so forgive my nerves. Bismillah. I love you. Because I know you hold within you his greatest secret. We just don't know it yet. Others have only just found out. The Spirit of God in your essence reminds me of his presence, and he is present right now. We are exactly where we are supposed to be. Before our mother's wombs became midnight cocoons for mortals with butterfly potential to fly forth, before my existence was dressed in flesh and given as a gift upon which God's names are made manifest. Before his breath in Adam made Satan adamant he would not bow. Before the vow to deceive the sons of Adam and his daughters. Before her waters broke, before Jesus spoke, before Abraham broke the idols, this very moment was written, glistened in existence. Before I uttered a sentence that was a return ticket to my essence, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. Before I fell in love with a man unlettered who inhaled our maladies and exhaled galaxies for us to know Allah in all his majesty. A man whose face could make the sun set in shyness and make the full moon become a crescent, daring not to challenge his brightness before I was blinded by Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This moment was written before I married my reflection, whose breath tastes of prayer and remembrance. Before I loved him and lost him and found him again. Heart opened, broken and opened again before my white gold wedding ring. Before I realized the blacks of his eyes resemble the pots of ink that my destiny was written with. This moment was written before Coltrane first blew. Before I knew what I knew, before I didn't know what I'll know tomorrow, before the eventual sorrow that comes from burying loved ones, and that bittersweet moment when the tears subside and you realize the rivers of life just keep flowing. She no longer needs your sympathy. She's realized the fact that we are all notes in God's symphony. He is the cause and the cure, the before and the after evermore. Before that cold December morning when God spoke through me, when God spoke to me through him and invited me on a journey over the hedges of make-believe into the gardens of reality. He said, I am here, right here. Do you not want to know me? I created the universe for you and you for me. Do you not want to know me? I was a hidden treasure and I love to be known. Do you not want to know me? As the frost settled on the ground, my purpose was suddenly clear to me. All sights and sounds pointed to Rabbil Alameen. Before I witnessed the intricacies of the veils that imprisoned me. Before I learned to seek God's face in the city and see his names manifest in between breaths all around me. Ya Aziz, Ya Salam, Ya Latif, Ya Awal, Ya Akhir, Ya Zahir, Ya Batin, Ya Awal, Ya Akhir, Ya Zahir, Ya Batin, Ya Awal, Ya Akhir, Ya Zahir, Ya Batin. I'm basking in this moment because I know we were chosen to share it. Ameen. So I'm going to do
do one more piece, inshallah. You know, I need to tell you something. So this morning I woke up and I had like butterflies in my stomach, and like I was gonna be performing, but I didn't have any invitation to perform anywhere. And I was like, yo, what's happening to me? So something said, Sakina, try and memorize this poem because you don't know what Allah might open. And today I was in the hotel and Sister Ashaki said to Samiha, you should have put Sakina on the bill today, you know, you should have given her the opportunity to perform. And Samiha was like, would you want to perform? And I was like, I don't know, yeah, okay, sure. And so I kind of tried to memorize this poem that I wrote. This poem was about two people. It's about my Sheikh, Sheikh Mahi, and it's about Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And it's a poem that I wrote after I spoke to Sheikh when he was in Medina, Al-Munawwara. And you know, we're so fortunate to have guides that we can speak to. You know, like, I have friends from other tariqas, and they're like, you can call your sheikh, like, you can visit him and sit with him and eat with him and ask him questions. And I'm like, yeah, mashallah, alhamdulillah, tabarakallah. So this piece is really like in gratitude to Allah, actually, for giving us the opportunity to have people like that in our lives. And it's called His Voice Sounds Like Medina. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم His voice sounds like Medina al-Munawwara. Illumination clings to his every word. I can see it with my heart. I can feel it from afar. Last night, my chest was pierced by Muhammadan light through my Sheikh al-Murabi, who is in the city of my Nabi, Ya Ahmed, Ya Mahmoud. This love is contagious, and how could it not be? His heart beats away from Masjid al-Nabawi. A green dome crowns the final home of he who made my Lord known to me, Ya Habibullah, Ya Rasulullah. I close my eyes and I am there, lost in the Prophet's mosque with no desire to be found by anyone other than him. Oh, how I wish I was an Ansari, awaiting the arrival of this noble Hashimi, grazing the edge of the city, gazing into eternity. Oh, how I wish it was me that first saw God's beloved and Abu Bakr as-Siddiq illuminating the horizon. I wish I had sung with the women, Jita Sharaf Tal Medina, Marhaban Ya Khairada. I can smell the musk from Medina Tel Nabi when he talks to me. I can feel the breeze from Jannat al-Baqi when he prays for me. And in that moment, I am certain I was not in London. In that moment, I was grazing in an earthly, heavenly garden, my tears seeping into the carpet, my heart seeking my beloved. His prayers sound different from Medina, as though his vocal calls are encased with even more grace. I imagine even more nur decorates his face, reflecting the secret of the Prophet resting in that place. Nabi ar-Rahma, Mustafa, Taha. And from this blessed city, he answers a call from me, his poverty-stricken murid, continents away, calling just to say, Salam alayka Sheikh Mahi, how is Medina, ya Sayyidi? Salam alayka Sheikh Mahi, how is Medina, ya Sayyidi? I can hear the love in his heart when he tells me how beautiful it is in this courtyard of his beloved. By Allah, I can feel it. And some of that love has made its way into my broken heart, and his light heals it. The moon is glowing on this Ramadan evening, and some lovers of God are huddled around one telephone, speaking in hushed tones as though we were sitting with him under a lavender sky in Medina, the land that gave solace to the final prophet. Sheikh, please greet the Prophet for me, I plead. In your prayers, Ya Sheikh, please remember me. He is my gate and you are my means, and I am in need. He sends a symphony of prayers my way. Every single prayer hit me like a light ray. May the love of the Prophet fill your heart, he said. Ameen. May the love of Allah fill your heart, he said. Ameen. May you know the secrets of Allah, and may Allah love you. Ameen, Ya Sheikh. Ameen. I never knew Medina had a love song that clings to the voice of its lovers. But yesterday, I heard it on the voice of my Sheikh, and it serenaded my soul. Thank you.
The,
This is the legacy of Sheikh Ibrahim. This is the legacy of Sheikh Hassan Sisi. This is the legacy. I don't have to say anything else. She said everything. Okay, we have to make some honorable mention. Our Sheikh insisted on this, and he's correct. And to show you that it's not just international, but amongst the Brotherhood of Tijanis, we have representatives, Sheikh Abdulaziz, the grandson of Hajj Malik C, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he is here with us today. Please honor him now, inshallah. Honor him. This is to show that in the end, we're one. In the end, we're one. The next person, honorable mention, we have to show our respect to this person, Imam Zamir. He's the president of Sada International. It is because of Imam Zamir that for the past 3 years, our Sheikh, please, Imam Zamir, our Sheikh, Sheikh Mahid, goes to Hajj every single year. For those of you who have been on social media, you saw the dua that Sheikh Mahid was making at Arafat. That dua, Allah blessed Imam Zamir to be the facilitator of that dua. Any one of us who benefits, and the whole ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam benefit, the Jamaat of Hajj Ibrahim Anyas radiallahu ta'ala benefits, and then the followers of Sheikh Hassan Sisi and all of the family of the Sisis and the Anyas benefit. Alhamdulillah, that dua, we have to thank, in part, thank Imam Zamir. Thank you very much, Imam Zamir. So, inshallah, the moment that everyone's been waiting for is coming soon. It's coming soon. But for now, I want to introduce the grandson of Sheikh Hassan's, one of Sheikh Ibrahim's murids, direct murids, and the companion. Everywhere you go, you see pictures of Sheikh traveling internationally. Everybody sees Chief Elijah Dukadi from Ghana, the Gumba Chief. This is the grandson of Chief. He's coming to serenade us with his zikr. And that is the intermission point, but let's stay and listen to the zikr. Wallahi, anybody listening to the zikr, not performing, anyone listening to the zikr on the Day of Judgment, you have a portion of Al-Jannah just because of listening, inshallah. So without further ado, we're going to go ahead and listen to the zikr and then set up the stage for Sheikh Mahi, inshallah, and we'll continue in our program. I know it's hot, I know, but alhamdulillah, this is beautiful, barakallah. So Chuck, let me get... Alhamdulillah, so bismillah.
وصول جميل ما سقينا بأبلياء النبي محمد تاق قوما لم يكذب بربيا وجوا بفياف في المعارف لم ترم فقد قصر الأقطاب عن درك شاويا بفضل إله الناس جل جلاله فهم برسول الله تعالى بيا حلفت يمينا إنني لا يغبني حلفت يمينا إنني لا يحبني سوى أسعد ولا أقصو فيها لبغنيا وقد علم الأقوام أني خديم فوصل حبيب الله يلفى بوصليا وما قلت قولي شادحا متبجحا وما مسني سقر يغيب عقليا وإن خطوتي للأنام سادة وإن خطوتي للأنام سادة فلم يشك يوما مراني وخاطيا وما قلت هذا دون إذن وإنني لأكتم سرا لا يباع لغيري رسول من المولى وآدم لم يقم ويبقى رسولا دائما ومعظما الله الله إلا الله
إلا لا
And this is the part of the adab that we have, and that we were taught by this particular way and understanding of Islam that we are following in. So I want to go ahead and introduce Imam Abdullahi from Ann Arbor, Michigan, to come up and present to us and introduce to us our Sheikh Mai Sisi. Bismillah. Without further ado, Imam Abdullahi.
As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah. All praises are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the beneficent and the most merciful Lord of this world and the hereafter. The only one we seek is refuge. The only one we seek is assistance in worshipping Him the way we ought to be worshipping Him. Dear beloved brothers, I'm honored and humbled to stand in front of you, in front of my shuyukhs, in front of the scholars that are sitting here in the front rows. Each and every one of them who stood on the podium have said enough that could take us home, that could last us until the next year arrives. Professor Jang, I have known him through the internet and through one of his students in Ann Arbor, Musuleiman Diouf, whom had introduced me to you through just hearing from you so much about the tasawuf. And I honor you for that, may Allah increase what you're doing online and in your classes. And the Imam, what you also said about our Sheikh is what we all know, that's what we all live. And we're gathered here for today. And I was asked to introduce the Sheikh, but what happened is they haven't told you the core of why I'm standing here. There's a reason why we have this hall as full as it is. There is efforts that were spent. There were time. There were money. There were sleepless nights, lots of conference calls to get this thing together to where it is. And there is an obligation on our part to see that this is done right. I will introduce to you our Sheikh first. Beloved Sheikh Mahi Sisse, the beacon of light, the nur that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has set forth in this universe, illuminating from Senegal, way down to far Asia, down to Latin America, and back into Europe, illuminating wherever he goes, he shines the light of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah had blessed him, mashallah, with a gift of seeing him and loving him. With a gift of seeing him and loving him. And may Allah continue to protect him from an evil eye and an evil mind and an evil tongue. And Allah grant you, Sheikh, a long life and a good health and continue to increase your maqam. Sheikh Mahi Sisse, at a young age, memorized the Quran in Senegal. Not so many people knew how old he was when he memorized Quran because he was so young. Upon memorization of the Quran, he studied with his father, Sidi Ali Sisse. Sidi Ali, the first Khalifa of Sheikhana, wa awalibuna, our father, our spiritual father, our connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Sheikh Ibrahim Nasruddin. Sidi Ali Sisse, who married to the first oldest daughter of Sidna, of Sheikhana Sheikh Ibrahim Yasra Jalal Sayyidina Fatima Zahra. May Allah continue to bless her with good health and long life. Produce to us Sheikh Mahisi Serad, may Allah be pleased with him and continue to increase him. He memorized Quran in Medina through the hands of Rabbani, who was a teacher of Mauritanian descent, whom Sheikh Ibrahim Yasra Dilan brought to Senegal to teach the children the Quran al-Karim. He memorized and he studied through his father and through the community of Medina, because Medina Bay is a university by itself. There were scholars that are specialized in every domain of knowledge that you would look for. Allah blessed him to study through them. And from there, he took a journey to Egypt and studied at Jamiat Azhar and attained a master's degree from Azhar. Since then, I've heard he even came back to Senegal and grabbed each and every single book of Sheikh Ibrahim, finding a teacher who will teach him to him for him to master it as he mastered them today. He went through that, and from there, he followed the footsteps of his beloved brother. I will not say much about Sheikh Hassan, because we said in Wolof, if a, I will try to translate it. If a rabbit eats a fruit from the tree, he should be grateful from the trees, the animals that live up on the tree, because a rabbit doesn't climb the trees. If I'm here today, it is by the blessing of Sheikh Hassan. To him we know, most of us got what we got, be who we are, because we knew no Allah, we knew no deen, we knew no nothing other than what Sheikh Hassan had taught us. They've said enough about that. But Sheikh Mahi came in and Allah blessed him to give him the torch that Sheikh Hassan had given him to carry on teaching and being the principal of that school, the AAII, which he is teaching, and we've seen how many children are memorizing. The program is expanding. Through the day, the kids are not only memorizing Quran, they're going through the curricular program to learn English and French, graduating from the school, and immediately can be accepted in any university. University of Dakar amongst them. And they graduate from there with a high school diploma that they can go anywhere and study. This is from the efforts of Sheikh Mahisi Said. He had given us all of this, and he was just recently coming back from a long trip just to shine that beacon that Allah had given him. Just coming back from Singapore and heading back to another journey. Never stopped and never gotten tired. Talk to him today, he said, you never get in the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no way, no time of being tired of it. Talk about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We say he is generous. Ask those who live in Medina Bay, those blinds and handicapped and those who do not have enough in their pockets, every morning lining up in front of Sheikh Mahi's door to get a provision on a daily basis. That's generosity. Talk about knowledge. Ask about those who heard him speak. Ask about those who heard him teach. Talk about knowledge. They will tell you how, what is knowledge. That's what he was known as, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Talk about humility, humbleness. Ask anybody who sat with him. The sister Sakina said, you call him at any time. He goes to Mecca, Medina, stands up in Jabal Arafah and calls amongst his disciples. I was fortunate one day he called me. I missed the call from Arafah. He left me a message telling me he's calling me from Arafah, made a dua. I called him back when I heard him say, I was so happy that I didn't get the call because I got to preserve the dua. That is our beloved Sheikh. But before we get him to come and stand and talk to us, let us remember one thing that Allah told us in the Quran. He said, Alif Lam Mim Dhalika Kitab, La Rayba Fihi Hudan Lil Muttaqin Alladhina Yu'minuna Bil Ghaib Wa Yuqimuna As-Salah Wa Mimma Razaqnahum Yunfiqun. They spend from what he gave them. Allah had given us all the possibilities to come here. Allah had given us possibility to buy tickets and show up here for the love and respect of Sheikh Hassan. How many times do we want to see this carry on? Do we leave it on the shoulders of some of these brothers who spend their money and time, or do we come and say, brother, thank you very much for effort well done. This is my participation. But Allah told us these are the believers. وَمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. These people, I would be the only one that would be مُفْلِحُونَ. They would be the righteous one. Allah told us, لَنْ تَنَارُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. You will not attain righteousness unless you spend from what you love. What do we love more? What do we love more? Money. Infiqo. Infiqo, Allah told us, Infiqo mima razaqnaakum min qabli an yati ahadakum al-maut. Fayaqul rabbi, lawla akhatani ila ajlin lawla akhatani la sadaqana wa kun min as-salihin. La ila ajlin khayban la sadaqana wa kun min as-salihin. Oh Allah, if you give me a chance, spend from what I gave you before death becomes you. Spend from what I gave you before death becomes you. And then what you will say, oh Allah, would you just give me a minute so I can spend from what you give me? When the moment comes, there will be no time. There will be no time. These will be the times when you and I can spend and hoping to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you and I can get to that investment and find it. 401k you do and you spend on it. That is your retirement plan. Do you know if you're going to cash it? You may be gone tomorrow, but the $100 that you will put on this table, you know for sure Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would multiply it. That is a guaranteed investment. Allah would not let anybody's effort go in vain. But here's the deal. Last time we did the fundraiser, we asked for people to donate. We wanted people to donate thousands of dollars. We got a lot of commitment. But Ajib told me that not many of those commitments were fulfilled. Today we'll make it easy. Everybody that is in the podium, we can make it one shot, one person pay for all, and then I'll be done. Or we can make sure that each and every one of us in this podium gives $100. $100. If you're going to donate, raise your hand. Somebody will come and get it, and we'll get a commitment. Takbir, Allah. There's another one, takbir, that's 200. Takbir, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We said we have the hall is full. And I got 9 people, 10, 11. It is said, ما نقص مال من صدقة. The money of a wealthy person would not be decreased by giving. So give, you will not be gone. Jibril said, Allahumma atil munfiqa khalafa. Jibril said to Allah, Allah, give the one who gave replacement. Give and you will get a replacement. Young man gave us $50. Pray for him. We get 2020s. Now everybody should give. Young, old, male, female, everybody, 2020. Give it up, let it come down. We need to help Ajib and the Jamaat so they can finish, make us another conference next year. Just give him what you got. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you for it. So inshallah, everybody be seated and be quiet so we can welcome our beloved Sheikh Shah Mahisise. They say, until you're quiet, Sheikh Mahi is not going to come on the stage. Quiet and seated, or he will just keep him on the seat until we're ready to welcome him. First, welcome our beloved Sheikh. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad al-Fatih lima ulqa wal-qatih lima sababana sulhaq bil-haqq wal-hadi ila suratika al-mustaqim wa ala سيدنا محمد الفاتح لما أغلق والخاتم لما سبق الناس الحق بالحق والهادي إلى صراطك المستقيم وعلى آلك قدر المقدار العظيم الله
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Wassalatu wassalamu ala Sayyidil Mursaleen. Sayyidina Muhammadin. Wa ala alihi wa sahabatihi wa man wala. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin al-Fatih lima urid. Al-Khatim lima sabaq nasir al-haq wa al-haq. الهادي إلى صراطه المستقيم وعلى آله حق قدره ومقداره العظيم رضي الله تعالى عن أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم المتشرف المحضرين لنا بهذا المحضر التعطيف بنظرة تأتي لنا بظهري وعن المد الأخرى الحضرات السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we are very grateful, very honored to come today here to celebrate the day of ziyarah of our beloved Sheikh, Sheikh Hassan Ali Sisse radiallahu anhu. I'm not gonna give speech about Sheikh tonight because all the speakers, they say enough about him. Thank all of them, start from Professor and Imam Furqan, and we thank all our guests who come far away to share with us these occasions. And we're greeting our auntie, Sayyida Aisha bint Sheikh, and all the family of Sheikh Ibrahim, and of course, all of us, we are the family of Sheikh Ibrahim. Because he wrote a letter to my father, Sayyidi Ali Sisse, and told him, La umayyizu bayna abna'i al-barina wa itba'i al-barina. He said, I don't have differences between my good sons and my good murids. So his good murids, they are his sons. And the proof of that, before he passed away, he has many sons who was a scholars, but he chose his Khalifa from his murids. For you to let you know that to benefit from your Sheikh is to love the Sheikh. So our gathering today, it's not to honor Sheikh Hassan, because Allah honor him, but to honor ourselves, to prove our love for him. Because Sheikh Ibrahim, one time, when he missed Ziyara, 2 years, and the third time, when he came, he said to the peoples, you used to come, you didn't find me, but you found Allah. Today, you come, you find me, and you found Allah. He said one of the awliya, he have intention to make Hajj. 2 times Allah didn't make it. The third time, when he get to Arafat, he said, oh Allah, the way you accept my first 2 Hajj, please accept this Hajj. And Sheikh Ibrahim said, if the ziyarah was for me, if I'm not around, you will never come. And this ziyarah also, if it was for Sheikh Hassan, and Sheikh Hassan's not around, we'll never come here. But we do it for the sake of Allah. Mm-hmm. And we witness that our love for him is for Allah. Because to love somebody and show him love and respect when in front of you is very easy. But even if he's Senegal, sometimes it's not easy. But now, nobody can see him except the truthful people. They connect with their sheikh all the time. But this year has proved that love that we have for him. The more you love your sheikh, the more you get benefit from him. And to thank Allah is not just words, Allah said in Quran, "I'malu ala Dawud shukran." Do action of thanking Allah. And this is one of those actions. We do this to thank Allah, because whenever we remember Sheikh Hassan, we're remembering Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, remembering Sheikh Ahmed Tijani radiallahu anhu, remembering Sheikh Ibrahim radiallahu anhu, remembering Quran and good minds and generosity and all these good things that we learn from him. Of course, if you have one day for his ziyarah, does not mean only that day we have to remember him. We have to remember him all the time. But what the sheikhs need from the murid after learning is to applicate what you learn from him. Sheikh Ibrahim, he used to say, "Muradul ashiyahi as-sadiqun faqat li'annahum humul ahlu lil-wirasati." He said, the mashayikh, they need among the murid only the truthful murids, because only they are the people who are able to carry the secret from the sheikhs. Because you know that the same Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that Abu Bakr Siddiq has seen and said, anything he said is true, is the same Prophet that Abu Lahab has seen and was saying what he's saying is not true. And he saw him before even Abu Bakr Siddiq. So Sheikh Hassan, many people, they saw him. Some people, what they know about him is his generosity, his humbleness, his voice, nice voice, reading Quran. But Allah gave him the secret of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And his action, all this, he do a lot to help the deen, to help the humanity. This he learned it from his grandfather. Because when he sent them to Egypt to study, that time he told them, "I didn't send you for knowledge, but your time is changed. You have to go some school to get diploma." But after they have those diplomas, they come and still learning from him. But he told them, make sure you carry good things from your nation and to all over the world. And Sheikh Hassan, he do that. Because he bring knowledge to Senegal, but his him is not for Senegal only. It's for all the creation of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. I can't say the hadith that I heard him said the most is the hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "Al-khalqu kulluhum 'iyalullah, ahabbuhum ila Allah, anfa'uhum li'iyali." Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, all the creation, they are the family of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. The best among them who benefit the creation the most. So after Iman Billahi Tabarak wa Ta'ala, the best of the things is to work to benefit people. We have to do our best. Continue his work to help ourselves, to help our family, to help our society, to give good examples about our deen, to let people know is the deen of tolerance. Because this day, everywhere you go, when you claim they are Muslim, you are Muslim, or you are a sheikh, and they see 3 people, 10 people around you, they try to know what you believe. Are you terrorist? And Islam don't have anything with terrorism. Islam is the religion of peace. And Sheikh Hassan, he lived all his life, he do all his effort to give good examples about the deen. Some murid, I remember one of the murids among the people here, Sheikh Hassan, his way to da'wah of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala after permission from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala from the mashayikh is wisdom. "Udu ila sabili rabbika bil hikmati wal mu'izati al-hasana." He will change murid without telling him anything. One of the people here, he's now a teacher, he's an imam. When he came to Senegal, he had long rasters. Sheikh Hassan never told him, change this. Because he was easy with him. Because this is the way of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When Allah revealed Quran, he didn't tell people to stop drinking wine one day. No, that's not the way. But him, he said one day, he had the dreams. People was in the circle making wazifa, and Sheikh Hassan told him, cut your hair. And right away after that, he cut it. So we have to learn to have tolerance, to have, you know, wisdom, and to show people love, to love our deen, to help, because it's not enough for you to be good. You have to be good, but you have to help others to be good. That is strong believer. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, "Al-mu'min al-qawi khairun wa ahabbu ila Allah min al-mu'min al-da'if wa fi kulli khair." He says strong believers is most beloved to Allah than weak believers. And Sheikh Ibrahim said the strong believer is somebody who has good things and try to let others have it. You learn Quran, please help some people to know even one surah, three surah, four surah. Don't say this is very few. You know, hadith, try to teach some people, لِيُبَلِّغَ الشَّاهِدِ الْغَائِبَ, because that's what Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. You know how to pray, you know how to make wudu. Help others to know. You have knowledge, help others to have knowledge. You have job, help others to have it. You're strong, help others to be strong. We have to come together and help each other. Because everybody now said that what we have is good. So what rests is to applicate it and to show people good example to follow the way of Sheikh Hassan radiallahu anhu. May Allah accept your ziyarah, because the ziyarah for the sake of Allah is very, very big things. Because even if one you going to make ziyarah is not a complete sheikh, is big blessing for you. Because Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in hadith, that hadith in Sahih Muslim, that a person was traveling to meet, to visit a brother for the sake of Allah. In his way, an angel came to appear to him, ask him, where are you going? He said, I'm going to this village, visiting such and such. Do you have business with him? He said, no, I just love him for the sake of Allah. And the angel showed him that he's not human being. He told him, I am the messenger of Allah. Allah sent me to tell you that he loves you because you love your brother for the sake of Allah. Said. So everybody come here, he came because he came to make ziyarah, to show his love for Sheikh Hassan, of course, for the sake of Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala. Who traveled from Trinidad, traveled from London, traveled from different way, Detroit, Atlanta, Chicago, all over the America, to come here, we come to Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala. Because the intention make you walking to Allah. When Ibrahim alayhi salam said, وَقَالَ إِنِّي ذَاهِبٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّي سَيْهْدِينِ, I am going to my Lord and he will guide me. And he was going from country to country. When they put him in the fire and Allah saved him, he was going to Haran. And some people they say when he was going to Mecca. Anyway, Allah has no place that you can go to meet him. Even if you make Hajj, you go to Hajj. You don't go to meet Allah himself. So your intention make it going to Allah. And Ibrahim was going to Haran. And he knows, of course, that Allah is not closer to Haran than where he coming from. But his intention going for the sake of Allah to make it his trip going to Allah. So everybody come here, he come to Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala. May Allah accept your ziyarah. May Allah accept all your action. May Allah loves you. May Allah increase your love for Sheikh Hassan. Because the more love you have, the more benefit you get from him. The more love you have from your Sheikh, the more benefit you get from him. Because the more you love him, the more you love Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the ruh, the secret of Deen in Islam is to love Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because all what our Sheikh tried to teach us is to love Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But you don't, if you don't love your Sheikh, and your Sheikh want to carry you and guide you to love Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it's not going to be easy for you to love Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So that's why it's very important for the Sheikh to give good examples. Because if the murid love them, they will love anything they love. Now you come to this place, you see people you don't know where they come from Senegal, from Nigeria, from anywhere. Because we wear the clothes that we used to see our Sheikh wearing. But there's something more important than the clothes. So if we love our Sheikh, we have to love all what they used to love. They love Quran, they love Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they love all the salihin, they love spending for the sake of Allah, they love spending night praying all the night, they love praising Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they love making salat ala nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you love somebody, you have to follow him. That's what Allah said, qul in kuntum tuhibbuna Allah fattabi'uni yuhibbukum Allah. So the sign of loving Allah is to follow the way of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the sign of loving Sheikh also is follow his way. May Allah bless you all. May Allah protect you. Jazakumullah anna kulla khair. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammadin al-fatih lima aghlaq, al-khatim lima sabaq, asir al-haq bil-haq, al-hadi ila siratik al-mustaqim, wa ala alihi haqq qadrihi wa miqdari al-azim. Salatan taftahu lana biha abwaab al-ridha wa al-taysir, wa tughlaq biha anna abwaab al-shirri wa al-ta'sir, wa takunna biha waliyya wa nasira. أنت مولانا فنعم المولى ونعم النصير. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم انصر من نصر الدين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم انصر من نصر الدين. اللهم أعنا ولا تعن علينا. انصرنا ولا تنصر علينا. وانكر لنا ولا تمكر علينا. اللهم إنا نتوجه إليك بحبيبك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. تقضي جميع حوائجنا وحوائج من أسند إلينا حاجهم وتنظر إلينا بعين المحبة والرضا والقبول وتقبل علينا بوجهك الكريم يا رحمن يا رحيم يا رباه يا الله يا أرحم الراحمين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
انتحتها إياه على شرط كتاب الله تعالى إن تكون معلوم أن تسرح من الإنسان إلى المشاح لأن صباح والمعنى إنما مسيسا إنما مسيسا وإنما مسيسا وإنما
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما.
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. أما بعد، فأنا أنكحتك إياها أي اسم أي مريتي رسل رسل على شخص كتاب الله تعالى من سائر معروف أن تسلم من أحسن يسون القرآن صلى الله عليه وسلم. I show you treasure in the next week. The best of you, the best of best for the family. That's what prophecy lies in. So don't get up Monday and next day, take your wife, my book. Yeah? May Allah bless the marriage.
Amen.
May Allah make it. Happy marriage. May Allah give you good children. May Allah you understand each other. Stay lucky for you. And say, God.
Takbir! 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 Alhamdulillah. So this is going to commence the fourth annual ziyarah. We want to thank a few people and say one more thing. We'll give us 9 seconds. Come on.
Thank you all so much for coming, and I just want to really quickly shout out and recognize all the people who put so much work into making this event a huge success. We want to thank Yusuf and Zakir, who helped design the beautiful programs, the flyer, the envelope, everything. Israel, who Hamza, Nora, Anas, Tasneem, Abdul Rahman, Sister Aisha, and all the staff at the Schomburg. Thank you, everybody, for all of your help and all of your support in making this event possible.
Thank you for coming out. Good night. Thank you very much.
Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is saying to the man, Jibril, who came in the form of a man, أنتعبد الله كأنك تراه فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك. الإحسان is to worship Allah as if you are seeing him, if not he is seeing you. You have المراقبة المشاهدة. If you observe Allah in everything, you will end up by seeing Allah in everything, everywhere. In every action, you will see Allah.
يا سيدي حسن في سيادة.
سيد يا سيد يا سيد يا سيد يا سيد يا سيد الحسين علي الدين العابدين للنعيم مدد يا حبيبي يا حبيبي صديق بنا الدنيا إذا غبتم عنا وتزهق بالأشواق الله حنان منا وتزهق بالأشواق إن غبتم عنا ولو نفسا متنا متنا يزيدنا النبي نظرة المدى سيدنا النبي قول الله 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 سيدنا النبي نظرة ومدان سيد عابدين العابدين نظرة ومدان سيد حسن الدين نظرة ومدان وريات بجانية سيدي أحمد اسمي جاني نظرة وبدان فخر الدين نظرة وبدان يا أبا العينين نظرة وبدان يا أبا العينين لله مدان يا بلا عينين نظرة ومدان سيدي حاتم سيدي نظرة ومدان سيدي أنا عينيني حب الروابي يا بل عينيني 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 سيدي حسن مرة يا بلا عودي سيدي حسن سيدي نظرة ومدان نظرة ومدان